What's the difference between an email domain, account, address, and alias? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You know, based on the questions I get, I see a lot of confusion around these four terms. And I'll admit, they absolutely can be confusing. Sometimes they mean the same thing, sometimes they don't. But ultimately, especially when asking questions of your friendly neighborhood tech support person, it's kind of important to understand which terms mean what. So, let's go through the terms. An email domain. Well, that's very much like a web domain. If you take a look at askleo.com, that's a domain. It can be used for websites. It can be used for email. It can be used actually for some other things as well. But the bottom line is that that is usually the thing that identifies an organization. Askleo.com, of course, is a domain I own, and therefore it's part of my organization, my business. But domains like gmail.com or outlook.com or hotmail.com, those all also are top-level domains that happen to have websites associated with them, but that are also being used for email. One of the interesting things about owning your own domain, like I often suggest some people do, is that you control what happens on that domain. And you essentially have the ability to create an unlimited number of email addresses at that domain, such as askleo.com. I only have maybe 3, 4, 5 email addresses associated with that domain, but I could have millions because I own the domain. Now, email accounts. A lot of people confuse email accounts and email addresses, and it's absolutely understandable why. Because very often you identify yourself to your email service provider using your email address. But that's not necessarily always the case. For example, many years ago, my ISP gave me a username of user, 1234. But that had nothing to do with my email address. It was still what I needed to sign into to access my account. But it was completely unrelated to the email addresses that were also associated with that account. So an account is best thought of as a relationship you have with an email provider and what you ultimately end up using to gain access to the email that is sent to you and to authorize yourself to be able to send email as well. Typically, it's an account, username and password. The username is often an email address. Sometimes it's just the first part of an email address. And as we've seen, sometimes it's something completely different from your email address. Okay, great. What's an email address then? An email address is nothing more than a name for a mailbox. It is, for example, like leo at askleo.com, that identifies a specific place where email sent to me can be found. When you're not on my server, of course, it tells all the other servers how to get email to me. Askleo.com is the domain. Therefore, everybody sending email to me knows that they need to find out who handles email for that domain. They don't look at the email address. They don't look at the username. They don't look at anything in front of the at sign. All they care about is the askleo.com part. Then they deliver that email message to the server handling askleo.com email. Then my server finally gets involved and says, oh, this is for Leo at askleo.com. Therefore, I'll put it in this mailbox. Aliases. Aliases are kind of confusing. I will say that it doesn't happen as much as it used to, but it was very much the case that occasionally people would say an email alias when they mean an email address. There's history behind it, but the bottom line is that sometimes the term is confusing. The bottom line right now for an email alias is that it is simply another email address that lands in the same mailbox as another email address. For example, I've talked about leo at askleo.com, and that lands in a specific mailbox on my server. But so does sales at askleo.com. Everything sent to that email address also lands in the same email inbox as mail sent to leo at askleo.com. Therefore, sales at askleo.com is an alias of leo at askleo.com. All right, let's go for a metaphor. Maybe that will help make some of this a little bit clearer. Imagine a large office building. The office building has hundreds of employees, and deep down in the basement is a mail room, which receives tons of paper mail every day. Let's take a look at what the various characteristics of all that means. The domain is the address of the building. The Postal Service doesn't care about anything other than the address of the building. They simply deliver all of the email for anybody in that building to the mailroom of that building. The mail server is the team of hardworking mail clerks who then take a look at the mail that has been delivered to their mailroom, and they actually look at who it's supposed to go to. They then put it in the appropriate place, which I'll talk about in a second, for each individual recipient. Every employee has a physical mailbox, an inbox, if you will. And in fact, that's partly where the term inbox actually originates. That's where their paper mail is placed by the mail sorting clerks. Each mailbox is protected by a lock and key, at least on the front side. On the back side, the email server, in other words, the mail clerks, they can access all of the mail because they're responsible for putting it there in the first place. But there's a lock and key that prevents anybody other than the appropriate employee from accessing their physical mail. That lock and key, well, that's kind of a username and password. In other words, you have to show that you are authorized to be able to access that mail. You have the key. In the case of email, you have the password. Incoming mail is delivered, as I said, by the clerks who then take a look at who this message is for, who this piece of physical mail is for, and they simply insert it into the inbox for the specific person that it's addressed to. Again, an inbox, it's a physical box in our metaphor. Now, things get interesting because each employee may go by different names or titles or what have you. For example, I could be Leo, I could be Leonard, I could be Chief Technology Officer, I could be Chief Question Answerer. Each of those titles refers to me. That refers to the same inbox. In other words, they're all aliases. They all mean the same person, simply by a different name. And finally, there's that guy who takes the mail out of your box and puts it on your desk. That is your mail program. It's downloading your email from where it's been stored in the mailroom, your mail server, and placing it on your desk, AKA your computer. So I hope that kind of sort of works for you. I will extend the metaphor just a little bit further and say that let's assume that our mail clerks are really smart and they take a look at the pieces of physical mail that you get and they throw away anything that isn't business related. They throw away the junk mail. Well, that's a spam filter. That's the equivalent of a spam filter in the physical world. Hopefully, this helps you understand a little bit of how email works and what the different terms for the different components of the email system are all about. Like I said, for the most part, understanding your email address and knowing how to log in is usually all you really need to know. However, when you run into trouble, be it contacting your email service provider or online forums or support sites like Ask Leo, Once again, the terminology you use can go a long way in making sure you're getting the answer you actually need. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/17975. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.